Hello, everybody. Welcome to Managerial Accounting, Cost, Volume, Profit, Part 4. We're trying to achieve a desired after-tax profit when we have changes. Okay, so this is our new example. We're selling, we're kind of taking the example 3, but we're modifying it. So oftentimes when you're doing these cost, volume, profit questions, the way your instructors will try to trick you, at least that's what I'll do, is I'll say, okay, where this was the situation before, but now we're going to assume these new facts. The sales price per unit is increasing by 5%. My variable costs per unit are decreasing by 20%. My fixed costs are increasing by 287.5. My desired after-tax profit is 525,000. So how many units do we need to sold to be sold to achieve the new desired after-tax profit? Let's get to it. So let's just go back and take a quick look at the earlier question that I did, and this was in example 3, but we'll just do it really quickly here. My sales less my variable costs is going to equal to my contribution margin minus my fixed costs is going to give me my net income before income taxes minus my income taxes is going to give me my net income after tax. So what we discovered was for this particular question is we had sales, and again, my units, my per unit, and then we have our total. My per unit for sales was 800, variable cost for 550 per unit. Over here, my contribution margin is $250 per unit. My fixed costs are 622,500. And we know that the net income after tax is $350,000. Now, when it comes to going through and looking at these various examples, if I call my net income before income taxes X and my income taxes are 30% of X, I can basically solve for X by dividing the 350 by 0.7 or getting 500,000. If I take 500,000 times 0.3, I get 150. And I know that my net income after tax is equal to 350. X minus 0.3X is 350,000. 0.7X equals 350,000. X is going to be equal to 350,000 divided by 0.7. So that means that what minus my fixed cost got me my net income before income taxes is going to be 1,122,500. 1,122,500 minus 622,500 is 500,000. So I know that this works. If I take this over here, which by the way is essentially when I'm trying to achieve an after-tax profit, the way this formula works are my fixed costs plus my target pre-tax income, which is my contribution margin. This over here, when I divide this by the contribution margin per unit, means I sold 4,490 units to achieve that. And we're just going to go ahead and make sure that our work's good. If I go ahead and subtract this here, these numbers work. Okay. So this is the baseline situation. Look at the third video if you would like a more detailed walkthrough of how I went through and computed these numbers. Now, for this one over here, we're now going to kind of strip this out and we're going to put in the new information that's given to us. First one over here is we're going to assume that the sales price per unit increased by 5%. Now, if my old sales was 800, if my increase is 5%, my increase is going to be, basically, it's going to be a total of 840. That's going to be my new sales price. Now, another way I could have done this, I could have taken 800 times 1.05, and that would have also given me the 840. Let's go ahead and deal with the variable costs. The variable costs were 550, but they decreased by 20%. So my sales, my variable cost decreased by $110 per unit. So my new variable costs are going to be $440. Now, another way I could have also done this is I can take the $550 and I just multiply it by 0.8. I'm going to get $440. So over here, my new variable costs are going to be $440 per unit. So my contribution margin is going to be $400 per unit. Okay. It also tells me my fixed costs went from $622,500 and they're increasing by $287,500. So my new fixed costs are going to be $910,000. I now have an after-tax profit that I need to achieve of $525,000. So given the same information, we'll call this value Y. We'll call this the income taxes 0.3Y. So over here, Y minus 0.3Y equals 525,000. 0.7Y is equal to 525,000. Y is going to be equal to 525,000 divided by 0.7, or $750,000. To make sure it works, take $750 times your taxes, and $750 minus $225 gives me $525. Okay, so my contribution margin is going to be my fixed cost plus my net income before income taxes. Where over here, it's going to be $1,660,000. So my contribution margin is going to be right over here. Right, so I mean, the units I need to sell are 4,150. Once I know I have 4,150 units, I'm going to go ahead and put that in there. So over here, to check my work, I've got 3,486, 1,826. And then over here, I've got the higher fixed costs that I've already gone through and dealt with. Oftentimes you'll see textbooks will word this question like, oh, you're going to install a new machine. It's going to increase fixed costs by a certain dollar amount, but it's going to reduce your variable costs. So if you get a question like that, this is how you want to go through and deal with it. All I can tell you is that the best way to handle these types of questions are to create the variable costing income statement. And where you're going to see this come into play, which is incredibly important, is going to be our next chapter when we're going to be comparing absorption versus variable costing. So in any event, I want to thank you for joining me here today. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them below. And I appreciate your liking and subscribing to my channel. Have a great day.